excited this morning. Just the energy that's in here is it's really welcoming, and it's really great. And I'm excited to just share my story with you a little bit. And hopefully my story, you see maybe a little bit of inspiration for your own story as you go through it. Because I think we're all kind of on a similar journey along the way, in our own paths, in our own way we're doing it. But that's something that I've discovered, is that each of us has a very similar story through life. And that's really cool, because that's kind of like, oh, we're all humans. And that sounds sort of odd and weird to say, but it's really true. So before we jump into anything, I love videos. So I was like, let's show a video right off the bat. So swipe. Is it desktop? Yeah, there we go. Good. That was 2 weeks ago. I blew up that car. that is my second explosion, car explosion that I've done, where I've done the pyro for it. That's awesome, as far as I'm concerned. we did that because my buddy Chris Willett, who owns Sin City BMW here in town, he got hit up by Car Throttle, which is a YouTube channel and an online magazine. They got a couple million subscribers, and they were coming in for SEMA here in town, and they go, we want to do a story on Chris's car, which you just saw the little bit of in the shadows there, his car, which is I think it's a 1976 BMW 02. They restore old cars. And this one, that car, the X2, we used in our short action film, Action Action, in our car chase scene. And it's a BMW that's got mud tires on it and looks like it's, you know, been beaten up for, you know, years and years. And it just looks amazing. So they were like, we want to do a story on your car and what you guys have done for it. And I was like, sweet, that sounds awesome. Way to go, Chris. And Chris is like, what if we stuck a machine gun on top of it? And they're like, can we do that? And he's like, yeah. And then Chris called me up and said, hey, what if we blew up a car with the machine gun? I was like, heck yeah, let's do that. So that's what we did. We have friends, they own a flight training academy for the Department of Defense out in the desert. And they're a licensed weapons manufacturer, and they have lots of space that we can shoot machine guns and blow up cars. And so that's what we did 2 weeks ago. And the guys from London, from Car Throttle, like, lost their shit. I mean, they were just so excited about it. So that's not public yet. They're going to push out the footage at the end of November here sometime. So as soon as that goes up, my version is going to go up. Those are all my, that was all my footage. They have some more footage and everything. But to me, that's fantasy, right? If you look at it, you go, what do I want to do in life? I'm like, I'd love to make action movies. I'd love to blow up cars and have gunfights and kung fu fights and, you know, just have this amazing time, right? But 2008, that was not my life. Anybody remember what they were doing in 2008?
Graduating.
Graduating, yeah. Who somebody said it? 2008? Struggling, yeah. Well, it's time, at that time, right, this global financial collapse, right? Little scary time in society. But for me, I was selling insurance and investments. I have a degree in finance, and I had for 8 years up to that point been selling insurance and investments for Northwestern Mutual and then The Guardian. And then I had hung my hat at Orgel Singer and Associates, which is a very large insurance brokerage office here in town. And I was pretty successful with it. I'm a at that time certified financial planner, worked for a registered investment advisor, had lots of clients, was successful with it. I think I was the vice president of the local professional association at that time. And that was my life, okay? Until one night, 3 o'clock in the morning, I woke up in a panic, like literally having a panic attack. Anyone had a panic attack before? Okay, everybody raise your hands. I used to say, suck it up and get over it. Just breathe through it. Those things don't exist. Wow, did I have a rude awakening. I woke up. I think it was a dream that I was having, and it was basically, I saw myself, I was an 80-year-old man, and I was trying to tell my grandchildren why I didn't go after my dreams. And I couldn't explain why. And it freaked me out. I mean, like, I was thinking I was going to have a heart attack. And I couldn't shake it. And that thought of being an 80-year-old dude standing on the side, standing there trying to explain that I didn't go after the thing that I was passionate about just messed with me. And it kept messing with me, And so when I was 16, I was in the play Diary of Anne Frank. I played Otto Frank, and I had a blast. And so all through high school, I kept playing in plays. And then when I graduated, I went to American Conservatory Theater in San Francisco for their summer congress, and I loved it there. And then I came here to UNLV to go to the university to be an actor and get a degree in theater. And somewhere along the way, I said, you know, I probably need a backup plan in case this acting thing doesn't quite work out, right? So while I'm getting my theater degree, why don't I get a finance degree too? So I did. And one night I took an internship when I was in my senior year at Northwestern Mutual, and fast forward, all of a sudden, 8 years later, I'm still in that world selling insurance and investments, and I'm not doing any of the things that I dreamed about when I was a child. And so the first thing I want to leave you with is figure out what you want to do in life, or life will figure it out for you. And if life figures it out for you, you may not like where it takes you. And that's what I figured out. And I that's a mantra I keep with everybody that I run across. If I hear them struggling or something, they're not passionate about what they're doing. Most of the time, it's just they're not following their dream. They kind of just let life take them where it's taken them. And the cool thing that I've discovered over the last 8 years, is that when I figure out what I want to do, I can actually go do it. There's really not a whole lot that stops me at all in life anymore, okay? I want to go blow up a car? Let's go do it, okay? Yeah. A 10-year-old kid on YouTube taught me how to do the pyro, okay? It's available out there, guys. If you want to figure out how to do something, you can figure out how to do something, all right? We're going to blow up a car for HBO here this next month. And Clark County Fire Department's going to help me do it. It's on their property, and we're doing that for Addy Shanker, who creating a superhero action series for HBO. And we did a video that he saw, and he liked it, and he goes, hey, could you do that for us? And we're like, yes. And it's like 8 years ago, that conversation just didn't exist. Like, it wasn't even possible in my brain. And today, it's, yeah, totally possible. And a bunch of other things are possible. But let me go back to 2008 and kind of take you through that journey and how today comes into existence. So these are my terrible notes that I did while I was driving here last night. So that's before 2008, not really living a life that it was passionate or inspiring. So what do? I got excited. Hey, I want to do acting again. But I'm still stuck in the same place that I always was, which is, what do you do? And so the thing that you need to do is get into action. Just start doing something towards it. Because you doing something is going to figure out, well, that's wrong, and oh, this works, and oh, that's wrong, and this works. But if you don't do anything, you never discover any of that stuff. So I hit up the university at UNLV and talked to Menendez, who's the chair of the film department. I said, hey, Menendez, I've always wanted to be doing film work, but I never did any of that stuff. What can I do? Do you have a class I could attend? And he's like, yeah, there's a production class. You know, you can sign up. I was like, no, I don't want to sign up for it. I just want to come to it, right? I don't need credits, okay? I just want to come and hang out with y'all. And so he's like, okay. But clearly, he said, okay. So I was like, oh, sweet. So then I played hooky on Wednesdays, and at noon, I headed down to the university and spent 3 hours with a bunch of filmmaking students at UNLV. And it's funny, they've got a lot of projects that they want to make. They want to make a bunch of movies. And I was an actor who, yeah, I can do it. Pick me. And so a couple of them did. They picked me just because I was there, because I showed up and said, I want to do this. They went, oh, okay, well, we want to do this stuff too, so let's go play. And so we made a couple of short films with them. And that's how I started learning that you could do short films. You didn't have to go to Hollywood to do all this stuff. You could do it right here in Las Vegas. And I think I won an award at the Spring Flicks that year for like runner-up for best actor, which is great. I'm not that great of an actor, but it was like really nice of them to say. I was competing against kids 10 years younger than me. So, and about that same time, I'm still doing insurance and investments. That hasn't stopped. Got to pay the bills. My buddy who owned a company there, he says, I was telling him what I was doing. He goes, oh, we need a video. Do you think you could help me figure out how to make a video? I was like, oh, heck yeah. I got all these guys. They got all this camera equipment. You know, it's like they got cameras like this hanging out. It's like, we can't go talk to them. Do you have a budget? And he's like, well, I could probably scrape together $500 and we could do a video. I was like, I could probably get a couple of guys for that. You know, they could make us a video. So we did, and we created a video about pee testing because that was my buddy's company. He sold pee testing. I mean, that was in the insurance world. You need to test people's pee. That's his company. So that was our first video that we did, was on pee testing. And it was great. We shot it in our home, in my wife and I's home. And I acted in it, which was great. My wife acted in it. And we...
Service
announcement. Yeah, it was kind of, yeah. But it was directly, it's like, how do you do a pee test? What's that all like, right? So... That was great. And when we got done with it, he loved it, right? Well, here's the crazy part. Not only did he love it, but the national company, because it's a bunch of franchises that are all across the country, the national company, the parent company, they loved it too. And they hit us up and they go, can we buy your video? And so the video that I made for free, because I didn't make anything out of $500, it went to shooters and to editors and nothing to me. They go, we'll pay you $5,000 for it. And I was like, my God. It's like, John, dude, John's my buddy. I said, John, we can make money at this. Oh my goodness, you know? Let's split it, right? So we that was my first video, and we made a couple grand out of the whole thing. And I was flabbergasted by it. But so at this point, I know nothing about filmmaking, right? But what I did know was other people who knew stuff about filmmaking. I was talking to somebody the other day, I think it was last night actually, at this event I was at, and they were like, I don't really know what to do in the whole thing. I was like, you don't need to. You don't need to know how to do a lot of this stuff. If you're passionate about it, guess what? Other people know that stuff. And you can just get them to come along your journey with you. Quentin Tarantino has a great speech where he talks about when he started making films. He was like, I don't know how to direct people or to I don't know lighting or cinematography or acting or any of this stuff. And he was like really freaking out. It was his first real gig. And his mentor at the time says, you don't need to know any of that stuff. Hire people that do. You just need to share your story. Be able to communicate with them what it is that you want to accomplish. They'll do it for you. And he's like, oh, I can tell people what I want to do. That's easy. do this. So that's how Quentin does his films. He just surrounds himself with amazing people. And so that was the same path that I was taking as this, you know, with this pee video. It was getting people that knew how to do that and having them do the work. And I just kept repeating that. And the cool thing was because I'd been selling insurance and investments around town to so many people, it's like I knew how to talk to people about sales stuff, which I think a lot of creative people haven't quite figured out how to do. They're like, man, I'm amazing at it. I see you're drawing over here. And I'm so jealous that you can draw. By the way, everyone has the ability that everyone is creative. Everyone has the ability to draw. Like you can all draw. It's just skill, you learn. Some people are better at it just naturally than others, but everyone can learn how to draw. And I'm looking at him going, man, he's gotta be amazing. Because I'm terrible, it's like chicken scratch, right? What's that?
Stick figures,
yeah, I'm really great at stick figures, right? But train of thought, totally lost it there. With the train of thought. No, it's okay, this is me, right? I just to wrap up, I'm not going to be able to finish that thought apparently. So find people that's good at this stuff and see if they'll help you with it. The conversation I was having with the other person was they didn't know how to make a website for it. I was like, but you don't need to know how to make a website. Somebody else can do that for you. Just ask them if they want to help. You know, they literally want to come and play with you. I use that all the time. You want to come out and play? When I blow up cars, you think I pay anybody to come and blow up a car with me? No. I go, hey, you want to go blow up a car? What do you think they say? Okay? We're doing There's another video I can show you here or there, but we're doing superhero kung fu fights. You want to come out and do that? You want to do a kung fu fight with me? I mean, it's fun, right? And people, they're passionate about the stuff that they're really good at. And it's like, if you ask them and say, hey, would you want to help me create this? You'd be surprised. A lot of people say yes. So we start making some videos here and there. And the thought that I was trying to finish up with it was, I was the sales part. How do you make this passionate thing a business? That's the Rubik's Cube that a lot of people are challenged with. Because I was selling insurance and investments, I kind of knew how to sell things. And that's something that as a creative, you have to figure out. And it's not an easy thing, but the best way that I know how to help you figure that out is to find someone who's better at it than you and ask them how to do it. Like, find a mentor. If you don't have a mentor in this business, whatever business that you're in, you are doing yourself a disservice. Get a business coach in your profession. Someone who's ahead of you, take them out to coffee once a month. Buy them lunch once a month. It is a small cost. They'd probably feel sorry for you and buy you lunch. Okay, but ask them how they do it, and just say I just want to talk about my business and learn from you about what you've done in up to this point, and just spitball ideas. That will get you light years ahead of where you're at just by asking for help with the whole thing. About this time, we've made a couple of videos. It's been nice, but I had this. I was like, I want to do an action film. I want to do a kung fu fight, a car chase. I want to blow up a car. I want to do a gunfight. And I'm sitting in my backyard with my buddy Will, and he goes, well, it sounds like you want to do a bunch of scenes. Why don't you just do that? And I was like, but I don't have a script. And he's like, well, just film the scenes. And I was like, this is genius. I'm going to do that. So that's what we did. And along the way, we figured out some sort of like haphazard story to patch it all together. But we filmed a kung fu fight, and we filmed two kung fu fights, and we filmed a car chase, and we filmed a gunfight. And we couldn't blow up a car then at that point because I didn't know how to do that. But we launched a car off a 100-foot cliff, which was epic. that was our film action. And we won Best Nevada Filmmaker at the Damn Short Festival in 2012 by doing that. Like, there was no thought of, though I'm going to end up here. No, I just want to do this and have fun doing it. I don't know how to do this. Let's go figure it out. And that's how we did that short film. And it's funny because that short film, that energy that's generated from that short film created other things that I've been able to do. Because people knew I could find locations and, Adam launched a car off a cliff. He can probably do that. My buddy calls me up and says, hey, come down to this production. I told him you can do it. And I'm like, well, what is it? It's something casting with some show. I'm like, okay. I get there. It's a National Geographic show. It's filming here in town. It's called None of the Above. It's an international show for them, and they want me to do the casting for it. I've never done casting in my life. Okay. I don't tell them that, but I go, yeah, sure, totally. And I just started doing the casting for that show, and I did that for the first two seasons of that show. It's not a great show, but it was a lot of fun. And it's, like I said, it's on the National Geographic Channel. My name is casting producer, not director, but producer. And I got to do that for 2 years, purely because I'd done that. Literally, I came out of doing an action film for free. That two-year job came from that. And I also got to be, through that, I was an associate producer with Brain Games with those guys. And again, we blew up a ton of crap. I mean, like the pyro guys, and I was always in the van with the pyro guys hanging out and learning all their stuff. It's like, oh, this is so cool. But that process of activity led to more activity. And not just like free activity, but paid activity. The guys who are doing this stuff here for free, this activity that they are doing will lead them to other things. They will make connections. They will learn how to do it. I mean, like the technical stuff that he's doing back here to videotape this with the microphone and the cameras and then the edits that's going to happen, he'll use that again and again and again because he's doing it. And that process, that repetition, that's how you get better at whatever it is that you're doing. I do the National Geographic thing, the Brain Games thing, all the while I'm still producing corporate video work on the side, which isn't the most exciting thing in the world to do a commercial for an air conditioning company. But the skills that I'm learning to do that, I'm able to take in my other endeavors that we're able to do. And The Action Energy also got it teamed up. The director, Adam Zielinski, for that, he got hit up by Danny Shepard and Jeremy Lee here in town, who were doing fan fiction films at that point. Their channel was called Ismahawk. And they wanted to do a Nightwing series, which was a 6-episode YouTube channel series that was about the character Nightwing from the Batman Robin series. So Robin leaves Batman and becomes Nightwing, right? So they hit up Zielinski and said, would you be willing to do this? Because they'd seen his work on Action. And so they went out and created that. And I got to go along that journey and got to meet them and help them out with some of the stuff along the way. And through those relationships, they hit me up last year and said, hey, would you want to be Hawkeye in our action flick that we're going to shoot, Hawkeye versus Green Arrow? And I'm like, yeah. So I helped produce, and I also got to act in our short action flicky thing called Hawkeye versus Green Arrow. And that's got 4.5 million views on YouTube right now, and it's pretty sweet. And I was like, this is awesome. And they had such a great time with me that they asked if I wanted to help do the next one to produce them, which was Flash versus Quicksilver. And I was like, heck yeah. And so I helped them do that. And that's at 10, just past 10 million views on YouTube. And that video is what got us the attention from HBO, which has got us producing this next spot for HBO that we're going to do, which is their superhero thing, which is we're going to blow up another car. And I just got permission from the Mulaski building here to fly a drone up the side, and we're going to have superheroes run up the side of the building on that and everything like that, and it's going to be amazeballs. So I don't want to play the whole thing because there's nothing worse than bad sound when you're trying to do a presentation and people are like, I can't hear shit here, jeez. But I can't, it's nice to see, like you saw the explosion, like if I just go, hey, I blew up a car, you're like, yeah, whatever. But when you see the explosion, you're like, oh shit, he actually did that, right? So this is, you can check it out on YouTube, Flash versus Quicksilver, it should pop up there. I just want to show you some of the stuff with this because I think it's really well done.
Let's make this quick.
Don't worry, it'll be over in a
flash.
Get it? It's my name. I'm the Flash.
Look, Flash, just try to keep up, all right? I'm the fastest man alive, after all.
That's hilarious.
What? You didn't see that coming?
Oh, I'm sorry. You were saying?
Well, I guess you were right. It was over in a flash.
Thank you. I'd love to stay and chat, but I gotta run.
thank you for indulging me there. I love that. It turned out so well. I was like, this is amazing. Can't believe we get to do this stuff. That's some of the more the fantasy stuff that's like just coming out because of just that activity with the whole thing. Again, figure out what you want to do and go do that shit. Whatever that is. You literally, that's how easy that it's not easy, excuse me, but it's really simple. And the faster you clue in on that, the quicker you'll get there, right? So where's life at right now? Black Raven Films is a viable video production company here in town. I've got a couple employees that do amazing work for me, and we do small projects and big projects. This last year, we did an 80-person film, short film, that was awesome. And we're currently developing a couple of full-length scripts. One is an action flick, yes. It's just really difficult to get a good script. But the second one is a drama piece that we're in negotiation to get the story rights for, this epic, amazing story. And it's like, dude, this is what I want to do. And today, 8 years after that panic attack moment, I'm doing that. And it's like, I love my life. Like, I freaking love my life. And it's awesome. And I'm like, oh, this is so amazing. Through my journey of doing this video work, my wife, who sells insurance at Orgelsinger. Along the way, she's seen me do all this thing. She's like, man, he's going after his stuff, whatever. I hate my life. I hate my selling insurance. And she will tell you that. She hates selling insurance. But I started helping her learn how to do some stuff, right? And like film some things and edit some stuff. And man, she took that off like crazy. My wife has a YouTube channel. She has 30,000 subscribers right now, which is not a huge amount in YouTube universe, but it's growing. Today, she's in LA. She was flown out there for Hall's channel, which is a brand new channel that's launching. It's a local brand here, but they have several multi-million YouTube subscriber people. She's hanging out with all of them at their LA premiere because she has this YouTube channel, which basically started with her going, I like shopping for used thrifted goods, and I like filming it and talking about it. And so that's her life now. Like, YouTube pays her to produce videos of her and her friend Edwina shopping for clothes. How do you get that job? Okay? I don't know, but I've watched my wife over the last 3 years just grow and grow and grow. And I can tell you, it's all from hard work and passion for it. She doesn't care about the money side of things or anything like that, because it's not tens of millions of dollars or anything like some of these people that do this stuff. But it is revenue, and it's driven by her passion for the creation of it, right? She's creating content for her viewers, which her and Edwina are freaking hysterical. Like, think Hoda and what's the gal on the Today Show? What is it? Kathleen, yeah, it's them, just a younger version, and they're shopping for clothes, and they're awesome. But she just saw me getting really excited and doing the things that I wanted to do, and she's like, well, I want to do stuff like that. And so she started doing stuff like that. And today, she's well on her way of getting rid of the insurance side of her life as the primary source of income and moving it towards content creation, which is her brands. She gets a package every freaking day from some company that wants her to promote her brand. I mean, the amount of free shit that she gets is sickening, okay? I own a video production company. I produce videos. I have like no subscribers. This woman goes shopping for a living, and she's got all these people that are rabid fans of hers. A year ago, she had 5,000. She's blown up to 30,000 in the last year, and it's like, it's just exponential from this point. She gets new subscribers every single day just because she's pushing out content. So it's like, I don't know what your passion is in life, but I do know that if you can identify it and then go after it, you will have success. It's literally that simple. Identify what the heck it is and then just go after it.